Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel again. Today we will going to learn one topic, and the topic name is the topic is from class 10th syllabus, and the name of the and the topic name is quadratic equation. Hope you are able to see the board. Topic name is quadratic equation. So as you can see from the board, that today our topic of learning is quadratic equation. So in polynomial chapter we have already learned about quadratic polynomial. Okay, now quadratic equation, what is the difference between quadratic? First we have to learn about that what is the difference between quadratic polynomial and quadratic equation. First come the quadratic polynomial. Quadratic polynomial. What is a polynomial? A polynomial is the combination of a dependent and an independent variable. Now quadratic polynomial, as we have been discussed, that a quadratic polynomial, that's equals to ax square plus bx plus c, where a not equal to 0 and a, b, c are real. This is called a quadratic polynomial. Understood? This is called a polynomial. Next come to quadratic equation. Now, as you know, that what is an equation? An equation is a combination of algebraic expression together with an equal sign. Okay, that is called the equation. Understood? Now, quadratic equation. What is a quadratic equation? A quadratic equation that can be denoted as ax square plus bx plus c, that equals to 0. This equal signs come here, where a must be not equals to 0 and abc a real number. Abc a real number. So this is called a quadratic equation, and this is a quadratic polynomial. This is the basic difference. Okay, for a polynomial we will get the values of this equation by putting the values of x respectively. Understood? And from this equation, and what is the difference? From this equation, we have to compute the value of x. Understood? If one equation is given to us, from that equation, we will compute the value of x. And from a polynomial, the value of x is given. We have to compute the value of the polynomial at that point, that value of x. That is the difference. Hope you will be able to understand it. Now, this is not our topic, we have already done it. Next come to quadratic equation. Quadratic equation let's come to the definition of the book. What is given in the book? If px be a quadratic polynomial, Px be a quadratic polynomial such that Px equals to Ax square plus Bx plus C, okay, where A not equals to 0, then Px equals to 0. Px equals to 0 is called a quadratic equation. Quadratic equation. Understood? Now from here we are getting ax square plus bx plus c equals to 0, where a not equals to 0 and abc are all real. Understood? Next, standard form. I'm not writing the standard. This is the standard form. Ax square plus bx plus c equals to 0. This is the standard form of a quadratic equation. Next, come to the definition that is given. An equation involving single variable with a term having highest degree 2. Single variable equation with a single variable with highest degree of that variable is 2. So that equation is called a quadratic equation. Understood? Where A is the coefficient of x square, B is the coefficient of x, and C is the constant term of that quadratic equation. Understood? Next, move to one basic thing that we have to given, that check whether x 2x plus 3 equal to x plus 2, check whether this is a quadratic equation or not. So for that, first we have to multiply it. We are getting 2x square plus 3x is equal to x plus 2. That's implying 2x square, this is plus 2x minus 2 equal to 0. So we are getting a equal to 2, b equal to 2, and c equal to minus 2. All are the real value. And here a, that's equal to 2, that's not equal to 0. So obviously this is a quadratic equation. Understood? Next, move to solution of a quadratic equation. Solution of a quadratic equation. Solutions of a quadratic equation. The zeros of a quadratic polynomial ax square plus bx plus c, and the roots of a quadratic equation are same. Understood? The zeros and the roots of the quadratic equation are same. Now what is the root for which value of x? Since it is a quadratic equation, so we should get two values of x. Now that for which value of x this equation satisfying, that is called the root of this equation. Means if we put the value over here, the LHS, this expression, if we put the value of x over here and if we get 0 over here, so that will match to the RHS. So that value of x are called the root of this equation. Since here the variable's highest power is 2, So that means it has obviously two roots. Obviously, two roots. Okay, the roots of an equation depends on variable's highest power. Understood? If it's highest power 1, then there will be 1 root. If it's highest power 2, there will be 2 root. If the variable's highest power is 3, there will be 3 roots respectively. Understood? Next, finding the roots or methods of finding the roots of a quadratic equation. First is factorization method. Second, by completing square. And the third is by quadratic formula. Understood? First come to the factorization method. Let us take one quadratic polynomial, that is ax square plus bx plus c. Okay, if equal to 0, if these are ax square plus bx plus c equals to 0. Now, if alpha beta are the roots, then this equation can be written in the form of x minus alpha x minus beta equals to 0, by which process we will get these factors. That is called the factorization method. Understood? Now, for a quadratic equation, we will get these factors by one very interesting method, very easy method. That method is called the middle term factorization method. Let us take one example. Suppose we have given one quadratic equation. That equation is 2x square plus 5x minus 12. We have to find the factor minus 12, that's equal to 0. Okay. So, we have to find the roots of this equation. So, for that, first we have to factorize it. Understood? Then we get the 0. By middle term factorization, what we get, we should multiply 2 to 12. Understood? We will get minus 24. Next, we should factorize this minus 24. 2 minus 12. Next, 2 minus 6. Understood? Next, 2 minus 3. So, if we look at this factorization, then we should get 2 into 2 into 2, that is 8, plus 8 and minus 3. If we take these two numbers and multiply them, we will get minus 24. Plus 8 into minus 3, that is minus 24. Understood? And plus 8 minus 3, that is plus 5. So that's equal to 2x square plus 8 minus 3x minus 12 equal to 0. That's implying 2x square plus 8x minus 3x minus 12 equal to 0. Hope it is visible to you, the board. So this is, we are taking 2x common, x plus 4 minus 3 common, x plus 4 equal to 0. From these two, we are taking x plus 4 common, x plus 4 taking common, we are getting 2x minus 3, that's equal to 0. Now, since this product, these two product term are 0, so either this term is 0 or this term is 0 or both 0. So, taking x plus 4 equal to 0, we are getting x equal to minus 4, and taking 2x minus 3 equal to 0, we are getting x equal to 3 by 2. So these two value, that is the value of x equal to minus 4 and 3 by 2, these two are called the roots of this equation. That means if we put any values of any one of the values over here, we will get that the left hand side becomes 0. So let us check once, so that it is for your understanding. That is 2x square plus 5x minus 12, 2 into minus 4 square plus 5 into minus 4 minus 12. That is 2 into 16, that is 32 minus 20 minus 12, that is 0. Okay, and that's equal to RHS. Hope you are able to understand it. So that's why minus 4 is a root of this quadratic equation. Similarly, if we put 3 by 2 over here, we will get same answer. Next, move to, so this method is factorization method. Next, there are several problems regarding factorization method are given. So I suggest you that you should go through. If you are unable, then tell me in my comment box. I will help you. Next, move to another method by completing square method. For that, we have to follow some steps. That is, we are taking an equation ax square and quadratic, ax square plus bx plus c equals to 0. Understood? Next, taking a common over here. So, if we are taking a common over here and subtract this a, so we are getting x square plus b by a into x plus c by a equal to 0. Now this is x square plus 2 into b by 2a into x plus, I am writing b by 2a whole square. So b by 2a whole square I am writing here. So b by 2a whole square, that is extra. So we are subtracting again b by 2a whole square plus c by a, that equal to 0. Now from here, x plus b by 2a whole square minus or plus c by a minus b square by 4a square, that's equal to 0. Now this is x plus b by 2a whole square, that's equals to b by 2a whole square, I'm writing, minus c by a. Understood? From here, x plus b by 2a is equal to plus minus root under of b by 2a whole square minus c by a. Understood? So x equals to minus b by 2a plus minus root under of b square by 4a square minus c by a. If we calculate it, this is minus b by 2a plus minus, if we calculate here, this is obviously 4
a square comes. So this is b square minus 4ac. Now this equals to minus b by 2a plus minus root under of b square minus 4ac by 2a.
Hope you can able to see the board. Board is not showing. So from here we are writing that x equals to minus b by 2a plus minus root under of b square minus 4ac by 2a. So that's implying x equals to minus b plus minus root under of b square minus 4ac by 2a. Okay. So this is the method of completing square. This is the completing square method. Finding the solution. Okay. So let us take one example. So this is one question that is given. We have to find the value of x by computing square. Now this is x square, so obviously coefficient of x square is equal to 1. So we do not have to take any term common. It's a very easy question. That's why I'm taking another question. 2x square minus 3x minus 1 equal to 0. So taking 2 common, x square minus 3 by 2x minus 1 by 2 equal to 0. That's implying x square minus 3 by 2x minus 1 by 2, that's equal to 0. Understood? Now if it is visible, is it visible to you? So this x square is 0. Now here this is x square minus 2 into x into 3 by 4 plus 3 by 4 whole square minus 3 by 4 whole square minus half equal to 0. That's implying x minus 3 by 4 whole square, that's equals to 9 by 16 plus 1 by 2. Understood? So x minus 3 by 4 whole square, that's equals to 16. 9 plus 8. X minus 3 by 4 whole square, by 16. Should be possible, no problem with that. So x minus 3 by 4, that's equal to plus minus root under 17 by 4. Understood? So value of x should be 3 by 4 plus root 17 by 4, this one, and 3 by 4 minus root 17 by 4. These are the two values. Okay. If we are writing it again, this 4, 3 plus root 17, 4, 3 minus root 17. Understood? So these are the two values of x. This is by completing square method. So there are several examples. So you should go through this example, several method. You should go through the method and try it yourself. You will definitely able to do it. Next, move to another method. By quadratic formula. The solution of quadratic equation by quadratic formula. Now one mathematician
named Sridhar Acharya. Actually, this quadratic formula comes by computing square method that I have already show you. Okay, one mathematician Sridhar Acharya gave us one formula for finding the solution of quadratic equation. What was that formula? If ax square plus bx plus c equals to 0 be a quadratic equation where a